Dat is een beetje.
Oh, come on, Jack.
I was going to put that pan up.
Why not? Yeah. Thank you. Just getting me own back. Right, cheers.
I'm filming people like that. Well, I'm saying it for the benefit.
Look, you're not filming us today, then?
I'm not filming anything for radio.
You do normally.
I'm not
radio. Right.
I'm not filming anybody. You're filming.
No, you're not.
There's cameras around me.
I'm a public servant, exactly the same as the people involved. We've fallen foul of all of them, as much of the clubs as anybody else.
We don't get everything right all the time. We're only human,
I'm just here to talk to you, people to people, about what's going on. I may or may not agree with what you're saying, but that's my right. But what I'm saying is that, let's be reasonable.
You know, this man has given a reasoned argument as to why people on the receiving end of sanctions need evidence like this, because they are fighting for their lives. There's a woman speaking in London today, speaking in behalf of a dead soldier who is dead for 3 days after being sanctioned before he was found. This is someone who rightly or wrongly believed in fighting for this country. We're not talking about radical extremes here. We're talking about ordinary working class people who are being pushed to the margins, who are being rendered homeless. And that's all we're trying to do. People are fighting for survival. They're fighting to get enough money to keep the people going to school, to meet them, whatever. And there he is. That's all it's about.
That's all I'm saying. No phones. Not on you.
Well, you know,
film the only one. Like I just said to you before, I will film it. Not film anyone. This is the real media. I know, I've been all on the answer. That's what I get.
You're here to facilitate the peace process.
No, you're here to protect that. Because you're here to protect that, that's the reality. You are here to protect that. Did you come down and engage with the protest first? No, you came down and engaged in this.
No, you're wrong.
That's what you thought.
You're wrong.
I was watching it.
No, we spoke to the United organisers yesterday prior to speaking to anyone from the
government. No, I'm on about this morning when you just walked down here. You just come here before and you just walked straight in.
We've already spoken to
them. You are here to protect
government. We've already spoken
government. You're here to protect
government. I know you don't want to hear what I've got to say.
Yeah, because I've given you all the facts and you haven't got anything to say to it. Yeah.
All I'm saying is don't film this stuff for me, that's all. Be real.
Yeah, yeah.
Just manners, that's all.
Yeah, have a nice.
Thank you. against the weather. Not just their job seekers allowance, but also the roof over their heads. Did you know that once you are sanctioned, you not only lose your JSA, but you lose your housing benefit, which puts your tenancy at risk? And as we know, as our mayor says, Joe Anderson, austerity kills. Austerity has killed. Hundreds of people have died. They have died from the tax of this government. Homeless. He was sanctioned by JSA. He has nowhere to stay. Then if it wasn't for organisations like Reclaim, like Old Swan Against the Cots, like Uniting the Community, this man would not be able to survive. We need to set up solidarity networks, just like in Greece, and we are one of those such networks. We're providing the very basics what people need, not just food and ensuring they can keep a roof, but also the support from their communities.
Yeah.